Many old seaside hotels have lost their homely domestic comforts to a modern, air-conditioned, executive-style uniformity. But at Clifton Villa in Kent, at the magnificent Walpole Bay Hotel, the traditional English seaside holiday never ended.
It's very much a voyage to the familiar. People didn't want change. Being there meant happy associations, which they somehow wanted to repeat. And if they met the same people and everything else was more or less the same, it would have been a successful holiday. It was very busy. People tended to start their holidays usually on a Saturday, yeah. So bookings ran from Saturday to Saturday. It's been like a sort of pageant in a way, all these people, and it's sad to relate, but so many have gone now, passed on, but there have been some very good times in terms of happy people.
There was a continuity, and the children of those days, I still see one or two, there are still some people who come.
Well, my grandparents started it. They bought some land in Fifth Avenue and built the hotel. With some foresight, I suppose, they bought a large plot of land in Fifth Avenue, so they were able to build what was then just half the hotel in 1914, and business was so good, I suppose, that in 1927 it was extended to its present size. They doubled it, so... That just shows you how quickly they're able to establish the business. It was life, it was part of us. It was unthinkable, in a sense, to contemplate life outside the hotel. That is to say, you know, not being directly involved in it. Now it's actually happened. In a strange way, it's been somehow easier than I think we thought.
We actually took over the Walpole Bay Hotel on the 1st of April, April Fool's Day, and everybody thinks that was a very apt date to start. But we have total confidence. People are looking. They want to stay in England. They want to enjoy themselves. They want peace, relaxation. They want the old quality values. They want the standards of service. And this is what we're going to do here. When guests come to dine, I actually say that I make no allowances for the cutlery. They're privileged to be allowed to use it. It's been here since 1918, and it's dented and marked, and every mark can tell a story.
There's a small hotel with a wishing well. I wish that we were there together.
This is unique. It's a wonderful old building that's unchanged. And it still has everything it had in those days. We've got gas fires in the bedrooms, we have gas lamps in the hall.
Not a sign of people who want people.
If you go into a modern hotel these days, you can wake up in the morning and you can be anywhere in Europe. They have the same carpets, the same air conditioning, the same pictures on the walls, the same wallpaper.
We'll thank that small hotel.
Really has the ambiance of a bygone era. The atmosphere, can you feel it? Well, our son had a little saying when we were doing the organising for this. And there's a film, The Field of Dreams. And he calls it our field of dreams. Build it and they will come. And we're not even thinking beyond that. We're still building.
together.